anti-Afro Svengalis, just so we're clear, lightning is going to continue striking again and again and again, like it did with this trash ass live stream that we got word of. It's already been taken down. Take a look at this Mack truck, how easy it's flowing through dirt. Mack trucks can also haul dirt. Mack trucks enter into spaces where they know they can dominate. And that's what we do when it comes to our rights. We're going to dominate when it comes to handling business. And you have this freak up here who can never even have a man-to-man conversation. It's mouse versus man, because the mouse will be squeaking and can't get any words out. Whenever any actual man steps to him, he doesn't know what to do. He takes his orders from other weakling males and needy, desperate females. That's why the shit keeps coming down and will continue to come down. I mean, I can't think of a bigger insult. Someone like this, who can't even have a man-to-man conversation, thinking I give a shit what he thinks about me. When have I ever given a shit about what any of these freaks think about me? Violating my rights is the issue. That's what they have to do. They have to violate our rights in order to make any sort of impact. And you damn well better believe the impact's going to be hitting them. Just like I got another one of your videos down, you idiot. I will continue to make sure your shit comes down if you're violating my rights. You're violating the rights of my friends and supporters, and you're harassing us, or you're putting anybody up on your trash ass platform to accomplish the task, which is part of what he did. Laughing, cackling, that I'm like, what the hell is this? Like, what am I listening to? How is this associated to anything that's legal when you have a person up here laughing because they think they beat the system? I guess one of the complaints Gerald sent through didn't go through, that YouTube thought it was fair use. If YouTube thinks it's fair use, it's fair use. He's laughing about it, then at the same time violating our rights. So that's why that video's gone. Who in the world would sit here and think that they're doing something? They have content when it consists of violating rights. You got no content. You're nothing but a molasses ass, gelatinous spine loser who takes orders, who gets advice from other spineless freaks. I'm going to move on to the copyright strike situation with Gerald. Gerald was targeted for all types of harassment. You know, it goes in waves and it goes in cycles. So this other subject comes up thinking he can take over the scene and be Mr. Big Cheese. And he seems to feel, in order to accomplish that, he's got to go on this campaign of homophobic attacking a heterosexual man who's married with children, who's an ally for the LGBTQ++ community, my friend Gerald. So in order to do this, the person didn't use the creativity that he has within himself, because he has none. He's using Gerald's content. Really, let me give you an illustration of how significant this approach is. If you look on the screen, you see these two avatars. You see how the names of their agencies or churches are similar. The one with the white, red, like bird flying in it, started operating or was incorporated in 1969. And then up comes this other entity in 73, creating a church as well. But they have a very different angle about how they go about life. They're white supremacists. They practice anti-Semitism. They're white separatists, filled with hatred and rage towards anyone that they consider not to be pure white, as if there is such a thing. But that's their right to think that and feel that. You cannot regulate thought, feelings, and beliefs. It's the actions. Actions are what drove the original church into court, because the hate group started getting attention in the late 90s, early 2000s. First, Matthew Hale, the leader, was denied a law license based on his legacy of hate. And then his buddy Smith went on a hate-fueled murderous rampage through the Midwest. Two people lost their lives. Several were injured. So this church is going, oh no, we don't want any association. If it was an animal shelter or a baking group, they wouldn't care. It was so opposite of what they were doing. They went into court and won, and Matthew Hale got angry, ended up trying to get the federal judge de-existed. Thankfully, he communicated his plot to the FBI, and he was arrested. The FBI was on him because they were certain that he was involved with that killing spree. But they had no evidence, and you can't get a search warrant just because you know someone. You can't get a search warrant just because you share the same belief system. And Hale was not on probation. There was no chance to get any Fourth Amendment waiver to go into his home. And we know no white supremacist on this planet is going to authorize a warrantless search of their property. It wasn't until after he was arrested for the plot on the federal judge did they find what they felt was strong evidence of him encouraging that guy to go on that murderous shooting spree. And after the judge's family, unfortunately, was de-existed, her husband and her mom, by someone else completely different, not the hate group, he was applauding it. So he was in all the way as far as his hatred for the justice system, his hatred towards others based on race and religion. So what does this have to do with Rev G? The same type of hatred was being heaped upon him. We're talking threats. His life was threatened. He's being misgendered. His content is being used. You don't think he has a right to say, hold it, I get to decide whether or not I'm going to allow you to use my content? And he's made it very clear, you're not going to use my content if you are doing so in a derogatory, abusive manner. So the person who was taking orders from a female decided he was going to just have a jolly good time violating Rev G's rights. He got two strikes on one channel and got one strike on another channel. The other channel, which was an initial description of a backup channel, was removed. And based on what this person goes about doing, we don't know why that channel was removed. We don't know what, if anything, pre-existed before Rev G decided to exercise his rights. Just because subjects don't have content, it doesn't give them the right to harass and abuse and misuse other people's content for entertainment. Those who own the content have a right to file complaints with YouTube. If YouTube says it's fair use, then YouTube says it's fair use. That's where we are with that. I put articles in the comment section to kind of give you an idea of how extensive this whole situation went with the hate group, how it affected so many people. Attitudes and actions matter. Let's move back over to the situation, the lie about AAS erased messages in a chat. There are two people, one since 2019 and another since 2020, who have been harassing my friend Gerald Rev G relentlessly, constantly. We're not talking about the disgraceful service member who got in serious trouble for harassing Rev G for 2 years, 2019, 2020. It's a long time, persistent. So I had a wrench in this person's channel. And after a live stream was over, these two subjects went and left a bunch of derogatory messages about my friend. So you're saying I have a wrench in a channel. That means I have to tolerate attacks on my friends. And I'm not talking about somebody doesn't agree with someone. Oh, I don't agree with you. Oh, you don't know what you're talking. No, we're talking about persistent, continuous harassment. And they thought it was going to be cool to continue that on this page. I sent an email to that person and I told the person to demod me. Yes, I sent that message. This person puts up a message complaining, he's trying to raid my channel. So thank you. Thank you very much. He admitted the success of his channel depends on the free reign to allow unjustified abuse against innocent people, and he expects me to carry a wrench and allow that to go on. This person is lying. That person is the host of the channel where he says messages were deleted in the chat. He would have access to those messages. If you are a moderator and somebody deletes messages, the host can go get the messages. And it shows right there in the chat. So that's a lie right there. They were not in the chat. They were left in the comment section under the live stream. And they were harassing messages towards Gerald. If I have a wrench and you're harassing me or my friends, I'm going to delete your freaking message. I've been a moderator long term on 5 channels. And no one has a problem with my moderating duties. And these pages are heavy duty with people trying to spam, trying to impersonate. A lot of the messages you can't see. We're going to go and we're going to delete the messages. Now, for those of you who are not aware, YouTube has different levels of moderators. You can be a managing moderator, which means you can delete anything. You have the same level of authority as the host. And that is a status that I have on every channel that I'm a moderator. So screw you. I don't need no validation or approval by some freaking demons who think they're going to give me a wrench and make me sit there while my friends are attacked and harassed. Here's the silver lining. Every single one of the channels that I've been a long time moderator for, the host is cleaning up on YouTube. Quietly cleaning up. It's not demonstrative, and that's why they keep posting content. That's why they're still here on YouTube. It's creative to the degree that they all don't make all of their money on their own channels. They are providing services on other channels, different services. Not just what Gerald's doing with his music and homepages. I'm not going to get into what other people are doing. But you all ain't stopping nothing. And I'm proud to be a part of it. I'm proud to be part of a group that helps manage a channel so they can focus on the content for people who want to enjoy the content. And none of it involves extortion. None of it involves harassing people. If you gotta use illegal methods to gain money, you're losing. You are losing if you go to a channel and you have to be forced, you have to be pressured into giving money to get what you want versus someone is providing content and you're interested in it and then you support the channel. Extortion is just that. Desperate move. There is no other way the person can make money. The question that I get most often throughout the time that I've been here on YouTube, who are these people? Who are they? Don't tell me you know them. Hell no, I don't know these people. I don't know who the hell they are. What's their problem? There's plenty of problems that they have. Thank God I don't have the same ones. So here's the situation. Whether it's breaking the culture of silence, whether it's Gerald Palmer, whether it's Liz Martin, whether it's Professor Cupcake, and I can start naming, I'll go down the list. Okay, I don't want to bring anyone else's name up. None of us are being impeded as far as what we have access to in our life. Our family and friends are not disowning us. We're not going to be told we can't come to the picnics and parties. You're not kicking me out of my sports group. None of that's happening. So you can continue wasting your effort. You can continue expending all of the oxygen in your system. You can risk blowing a blood vessel because you're so pissed off. You're wanting so badly to have some impact on us that you're never going to have. That person who was lying about messages being deleted in the chat, we know where this stems from. This is a cowardly subject who is extremely intimidated when he feels he doesn't have a large army on his side. He starts reading the tea leaves to see, oh my goodness, I see the boats rocking. But there's a problem. You can't read tea leaves and be accurate when you're drunk. Stop trying to read tea leaves when you're drunk. That's why it fails. He thought he had it going on because he perceived, oh, these people are against AFW. He was too chicken to stand up, so use some bullshit excuse about messages being deleted in a chat. He's too chicken to stand up and do the right thing. That's why he's in the predicament that he's in. Quit reading tea leaves while you're drunk. It never turns out. People, you know I have more coming your way. In the meantime, you know the drill. Buyer beware.